Rain is a lot about early spring in Montana, and Montana is a particular thing where thunderstorm builds up and calm before the storm and big, really thick black clouds finally. Lots of intense thunderstorms in the summer. What it comes down to, it's the seasons, but it really is a person looking at the season is really the core of it. I don't think I've ever expressed that actually verbally, but it's always a person looking at the forest. It's not the forest itself. It's more like soundtrack stuff for the seasons. It's not particularly for any one person or any one locale or anything. What I want to do musician is provide a soundtrack. Life is the film and I'm doing the soundtrack. I had a few piano lessons as a kid here in Montana, but just a few. I never stuck with it. I wanted to play baseball. I think it was just hearing music as I was growing up, particularly instrumental things. And then by the time 1967 came around, that was such a great year for music. I said, I want to be in a band. And I heard The Doors, Light My Fire, and Break On Through, and The Young Rascals. Pianists, I like some jazz, but primarily the pop instrumental area, Vince Guaraldi, Floyd Kramer. But I was much more a fan of organists, Jimmy Smith, Dave Baby Cortez, Booker T. And there was so much great organ music, I said, I want to get an organ and play in a band. So I started playing in a band in 1967. I loved the sound of organ so much it didn't even matter what was played. I was so on fire with that sound. And then I heard Fats Waller play stride piano on a recording, and I went, that's it, solo and piano. I never would have guessed.
Thank you. Thank you very much. The next piece is for a little later in spring, and it's called Blossom and Meadow. Thank you. piece is by one of the great psyche guitarists we've had the pleasure of recording, Mr. Leonard Kwan, and it's called Opihi Moi Moi. The guitar is actually my favorite instrument. You know, when I feel something or I get some feeling in the heart, I always go to the guitar. When I first heard the Hawaiian music on slack key guitar, it just reminded me of particularly Miles City, Montana in May. It was just that feeling. There was no other picture. It was always that. Slack key means to play in the slack key language, in the Hawaiian fingerstyle guitar language on any guitar. You know, each Hawaiian plays things of their childhood and their upbringing and the part of the islands they're from, and I just realized I just do the same thing. I certainly cannot equate myself with them as a guitarist, but I have the same thing that I'm playing my pictures, you know. I just come from the big island of Montana.
George first communicated with me around about 1979. He sent me a letter and a tape of some music by Bolo Sete, a Brazilian guitarist. And he said, you know, I admire your work and I'd like to meet you someday. And so we began this sort of gentle correspondence. And then over the years, we got together a couple of times. And I recall vividly the first time I sat down with him and he talked about the music, about the Hawaiian slack key guitar. I felt this love emanating from him. And you know, that when that happened, you can't fake that. I mean, that was legitimately shining through his eyes and coming from his heart. And I knew that I could hang with this guy, you know, because he really loved the music, and we've kind of been really good friends ever since.
Thank you.
love recording the slacky guitars because I love the idea of having the recordings laying around in people's houses. And their kids hear that, and then some of them play slacky later. And the great slacky players gave me the language to start doing that, so I'll be eternally grateful. I first heard Vince Guaraldi sometime in the early 60s when Cast Your Fate to the Wind was a hit. Many, many people know Vince Guaraldi's music. His music is very much part of the fabric of our lives. But a lot fewer people know the man behind the music. I've always been a fan of animation. When the first Peanuts special was on December 1965, I watched it in the piano. I just loved the piano. And it was, of course, Vince Guaraldi. But after I heard the Charlie Brown Christmas, when he came out with a new record, I always got it. I would always find out when a Peanuts special was on, because that was my next, not so much a music lesson as what tunes are in here that I could like work out on solo piano. Thank you.
The great harmonica traditions, there's basically four that are the biggest, and that's old-time country, blues, Irish, and then the classical, with playing with the chromatic harmonica, with the little bar on the side to move the notes up chromatically half step. And I don't do any of that. I don't do too much blues, but I do old-time country and Irish. That's Montana to me, and that's why I play melodic music or diatonic music or folk piano and it rings out. It's because it's like the Montana Great Plains. There's 1,000 shades of gray. There's 1,000 shades of brown that the dust is. This is a particular type of actual physical color that's really kind of unique to here. Looking at the blue through the green, seeing that particular gray and the white billowy clouds. The heart of the sensibility of what I play is the Great Plains, you know, anywhere northern Mexico through southern Canada. I mean, I'm very, very inspired by western Kansas and western Texas, I mean, and Wyoming. It's really Montana more than any place, but I find that when I go to an area of the Great Plains in the wide open space, that something happens to me and I start making up a tune or start practicing more. Something just, you know, kind of what you'd call maybe a slight purification or inner cleansing, something nice happens to me. I find that really every place has its vibration. I mean, every corner, every alley. It's up to me whether I tune into it or not. And I don't always. I mean, nobody can. I mean, or at least I can't. But if I can get myself in the right frame of mind, the right frame of soul, you know, I maybe could hear the song that that any place is whispering. I'm always trying to hear what's Wichita Falls song, or what's Lubbock song, or what's Red Bank's song or New York's song, you know, that's in the air. And it's just, I'm just a bit more in tune with Montana than any place else. And my goal is to be in tune every place else.
Next is an older traditional piece, which has been recorded by dozens of people. And it's sometimes played as a children's piece. And it's called Carina Carina. Thank you. Thank you. The way I play the next piece is inspired a lot by my biggest mentor on the piano, the late New Orleans pianist James Booker. And James Booker was the first one to take rhythm and blues and soul music and New Orleans music and make a whole solo piano style out of all those traditions. And this is two Vince Guaraldi pieces. The first one is Peppermint Patty, and the second one is called Charlie Brown's All-Stars. Thank you.
with Vince Guaraldi, I play more pieces of his than anyone's because his pieces are piano pieces.
Cast your fate to the wind. Take one.
Cast your what?
Cast your fate to the wind. Take one.
What is this? Is this a new tune?
Yeah. It's an original.
Oh, you wrote it.
That's right. Never been on a starter.
Thank you.
Yesterday, I had the great pleasure of meeting for the first time Mr. Chet Atkins, and he's someone who's inspired and influenced me for over 30 years. Now, Chet Atkins, that's my man, bass, rhythm, melody.
Well, when did you get into slack key? I'm surprised.
Well, in 1974, I heard this album here. Chet Atkins Alone, and the first song on the first side was called Hawaiian Slack Key, and I put it on and went, that's the greatest thing I've ever heard in my life. What's the name of that song? And Hawaiian Slacking. I said, well, that's the direction I'm gonna go in.
Yeah, I never knew that they play in a style very similar to what I play, and I never knew it for years because I didn't hear them play. But you know, those Portuguese and Spanish sailors went over there and left their guitars, and that's what they did with them. They didn't play Spanish sounding things. They played things that remind you of the ocean and the girls doing the hula. And I like that.
Let's see. You want to try that Pu'ana Hulu?
Yeah, I can't pronounce it or spell it, but I can play it. I call it Remembering Gabby in my little old album that I have out, Almost Alone. That's not a plug, that's a warning. Thank you.
Well, Chet has this, composed this beautiful piece, Waltz for the Lonely. I tried playing it on guitar, and I play everything in the G tuning mainly, and Chet was playing it standard, so it's really hard to play, and I messed with it for a while, could never quite get it, and one day I sat down on the piano and it just kind of fit in, so I play it as a piano piece. Well, this is where a lot of the music I play, just the inspiration comes from, is this very ground I stood on for years. And there's my old house there. I went and sat back there 20 years later and just thought about memories. These cottonwoods turned blazing yellow in the fall. It's unbelievable. And there's a little depression here. It's only about a foot, foot and a half deep. But they pour this full of water and freeze really quick. And this is where skating was in the winter. And every time I hear or play Vince Guaraldi's song Skating, I think of this little pond right here. Thank you. Thanksgiving was kind of a chord progression, kind of in what they call the circle of fifths. The picture it gave me was Miles City and Billings, and around, you know, November.
I'd like to do one more piece, and it's been great playing for you folks here again tonight. And this last piece is called Variations on the Canon by Pachelbel. Thank you.
Haven't been to Montana in a long time. Made up a tune. I haven't even played much of anything for 3 days yet. I'm a different musician for being here. I don't compose songs too often, but I made up this new High Plains lullaby and another gift from the state of Montana.